Hello people, I'm Bharat Acharya. Welcome to a new video. So in today's video, we're going to learn 8086 arithmetic instructions. We're going to start with the simplest instructions, that is add, add with carry. We go to subtract, subtract with borrow, increment, decrement. Then the little more powerful ones, multiply, divide, their signed versions, IML and IDIV. Then we will be seeing these instructions which are so popular in oral exam, Viva, CBW and CWD. They have a funny twist to them. So most people make a mistake if they've not learned this instruction. So we'll be discussing that in detail. Then we'll be seeing a negate, compare. Again, compare and subtract are pretty similar, but they are not the same. So that's again a Viva question. We'll be dealing with that. And then we'll be looking at the complex arithmetic instructions like DAA and DAS. Anyway, let's start. So, the first instruction, add. Now, before seeing these instructions, I'm sure you've seen architecture, you know which registers are how many bit registers. So, just to give you a brief, AL, BL, CL, DL and AH, PH, CH, DH are 8-bit registers and they are combined together, they are used as 16-bit registers by the names AX, BX, CX, DX. Now, our first instruction, add BL, CL. As the name suggests, we want to, it's the simplest instruction. Come on, you know, even if I was not there, you'd understand this instruction. What will it do? It will add the value of BL and CL register and will store the result in BL. Always remember, in Intel processors, the first operand is the destination. So when you write add BL, CL, you're doing BL plus CL, the result will be stored in BL. You can write add CL, BL, it will do the same addition, but will this time store the result in CL. A few things to understand over here. First of all, this is an 8-bit operation. Could also be done as a 16-bit operation. You know 8086 is a 16-bit processor. So the 16-bit equivalent of this would have been add BX, CX. It would do BX plus CX and store the result in BX. You get that? So all these instructions could be either 8-bit operations or 16-bit. If there is something particular, I will let you know. Like in push and pop, I told you, they are compulsorily 16-bit operations. So if there is something like that particular, I'll tell you. Otherwise, in general, every operation can be 8-bit also and 16-bit also. Next. Look here. When you adding two 8-bit numbers, BL and CL are 8-bit registers. So when you adding two 8-bit numbers, you are expecting the answer to come in BL, which means you're expecting the answer to also be 8 bits. The answer will be 8 bits in all probabilities. Sometimes it may be bigger than 8 bits. How many bits? 16 bits? No. You're adding two 8-bit numbers. The answer can never be 16 bits. Answer will be either 8 bit or at the most 9 bits. That ninth bit, that extra bit is called the carry, which will go into the carry flag. Are we clear? Let's take an example. Suppose BL was FF and CL was 1. You're doing FF plus 1. Now, FF plus 1 gives you 1, 0, 0. Treat FF as 99 for the sake of understanding, for the sake of simplicity. 99 plus 1 is 100. Similarly, FF plus 1 will give you in hexadecimal 1, 0, 0. Now, 1, 0, 0 is too big to fit in BL. BL will get 00 and that 1 will go into the carry flag. Are you clear? Again, if you do 0 plus 0, suppose BL and CL were 0 for the sake of it, if you still do add BL, CL, the answer will still be 00, which will still be in BL, but this time carry flag will be 0. So the point I'm trying to make over here is, after performing addition, please don't look only at BL. The answer is in BL and in carry flag. Don't forget to check the carry flag. In programs of addition, students forget that and that's when they lose marks because half your answer is missing. Anyway, so what are the two biggest numbers you can add? Suppose both numbers were FF. 8-bit numbers, the biggest values could be FF. So suppose BL and CL both are FF. FF plus FF gives you 1FE. Like 99 plus 99 gives you 198, same idea. So FF plus FF gives you 1FE, BL will contain FE and that 1 will go into the carry flag. I hope I made you understand add BL, CL properly. I hope you got the instruction. That was very simple, that was just a warm up. Now, an interesting instruction, ADC BL, CL. ADC stands for add with carry. I repeat, add with carry. It will do the same addition. BL plus CL will store the result again in BL, but this time it will add also the value of the carry flag. So the operation is BL plus CL plus carry flag. Now, carry flag is a bit, so it can be a 0 or a 1. If carry flag was 0, this is the same as add BL, CL. If carry flag is 1, the answer won't be entirely different, it will be almost the same plus a 1 to it. So if the answer was supposed to be 24, it will end up being 25. That's fine. The question is, when do you use add with carry? What does this instruction mean? People think it's just an ordinary instruction. No. There are times. All these instructions have very peculiar uses. If you don't know the use, what's the point of learning the instruction? When you're going to do programs, you're not learning the instruction just for instructions, you're learning them for programs. When you do programs, unless you know the correct use of the instruction, these are your tools. Unless you're familiar with your tools, you cannot build something really nice. So, anyway, so just to tell you the reason, the funda of the instruction, the concept, carry flag. Now, what is this carry? Is this the carry before this instruction took place, or is this the carry after adding BL and CL? This is the carry before the instruction took place. How can this be the carry after adding BL, CL? Come on. If you add two numbers and you get a sum and a carry, you don't add the carry back to the number. What sense does that make? 9 plus 4 is 13 in decimal system. 13. That means 3 and a carry 1. You don't add the 1 to 3 and make it 4. So this is definitely not the carry of this operation. This is the carry of the previous operation. This is what was there in the carry flag when you started this instruction. That means it's the carry of the previous operation. So here comes another question. If this is the carry of the previous operation, why are we adding that carry into this number? What's the point of using such an instruction where you're taking the leftover carry of the previous operation? It is used when you want to add two large numbers. Large numbers mean 16 bits or 32 or 64 or 128, anything, two big numbers. I'm taking examples of 16-bit numbers. Look here. 12FF, come on, everybody look here. 12FF is a 16-bit number. You can see that. You know 8-bit and 16-bit numbers, right? I have made a video specifically for this just to make these basic things clear. If your basics are weak, how can you understand big topics? Please check out that video in case you're not. So 12FF is a 16-bit number plus 0001. Both of them are 16-bit numbers. Add them. F plus 1 is 0, carry 1. F plus 1, 0, carry 1. 2 plus 1 is 3, and this is 1. So 12FF plus 1 is 1300. No surprises, that was obvious. Now, these are both 16-bit numbers. 8086 is a 16-bit processor. So if you want, you can add these numbers directly. Come on, help me do it. Side by side. You don't directly start writing big programs. You take baby steps, understand how to use instruction in the basic form. Then, before you realize, you become a champion programming. Come on, give me the program for doing this. Addition of two 16-bit numbers. Take the first number in BX, second number in CX. Add the two, answer should come in BX. Come on, instructions. Move BX, 12FF. Move CX, 0001. Add BX, CX. The answer will come in BX. Please tell me, did you understand this? This was when you adding them directly as 16-bit numbers. But for some reason, some hypothetical reason, you want to do it as two independent 8-bit additions. Did you understand my point? I want to add these two, they are 16-bit numbers, but I want to add them part by part, 8-bit and 8-bit. Absolutely fine. Mathematics allows us to do it. Let's do it. Then, first, what would you want to add? The lower bytes or the higher bytes? Tell me, what will you add first? Lower bytes. Why? Because the carry of the lower byte has to be included into the higher byte. If you understood this point, you have understood when to use add and when to use add with carry. Come on. When you're adding these two, you'll do a plain simple add. Why? You simply want to add these two numbers. You will get a sum and a carry which will go into the carry flag. Yes, carry flag. Okay. Some people think this is auxiliary carry. No. This is auxiliary carry. This is your main carry. Auxiliary carry is from carry from the lower nibble to the higher nibble. This is a full 8-bit number. It will produce a sum and a carry which will go into the carry flag. Please check out my video on flag register in case you have a doubt in this. Anyway, so now this is your carry. Now, when you want to add the higher byte, should you use simple add? No. If you use simple add, it will just do 12 plus 0 and give you 12. It should be 13. That means you will do A, B, C. What will it do? First number plus second number plus the carry of the previous operation. Please tell me, did you understand this? That's the point. So, let's do this using ADC as a program. First, we will take this full number in BX, then we will take this full number in CX, and then we'll add them part by part. Move BX, 12FF, move CX, 0001. Now, this is BH, BL, CH, CL. First, we'll do add BL, CL. Answer will come in BL and there will be a carry. While adding the higher byte, we'll be using the instruction ADC. ADC BH, CH, it will do BH plus CH plus carry flag. I hope you understood it. Now, I'm sure you're wondering, we could have directly done it as a 16-bit addition. Why are we doing it in parts? Of course, even I agree. I've taken this as an example to make you understand. Now, if you want to do 32-bit addition, that is not directly possible. That's such a typical program, second or third program most people do in college. In your practicals is 32-bit addition, 32-bit subtraction and so on. So if you want to do 32-bit addition, you'll do it as two 16-bit additions. First you'll add the higher part or the lower part. The lower part using a simple add instruction, it'll produce a sum and a carry. To add the higher part, you'll use ADC instruction. Please tell me, did you understand this? If you understood this, then I'm sure you'll understand subtract and subtract with borrow. Now, before I go ahead, I just want you to know, all of these instructions and all of these videos I've been putting on my own website. It is called www.bharatacharyaeducation.com. bharatacharyaeducation.com. It's just the name of this channel. Just put it together, .com, and you'll get it. By the time you type half of it, Google will already pop it up. Anyway, so all these videos, the whole of 8086 with all its interfacing, etc., there are videos created for it. There are about 25 videos of 8086 already put up, and we are in the process. I'll be wrapping up the 8086 channel within this week at the most. Anyway, so all these videos will be up there. All you need to do is log into that website. There's a very small payment. I've kept the payment as low as possible so that everybody has access to it. Yeah, some students requesting it for it to be free. It cannot be. It is a lot of effort for us to do this. Anyway, so log into that website. You can watch all the videos for the next 6 months, unlimited number of times. So you can watch them over and over and over again and learn from it. Not just the videos, even my book for 8086, this was last year's version. The new version is gone for print. Anyways, it'll be up soon. So even the video is, even the book is available on the website. All you need to do is just pay up. You will get the delivery at home. Okay. Anyway. Just wanted you to know that. So we'll be covering up the remaining, in the remaining video, we'll be seeing all these wonderful instructions. Let's go ahead.